Blackstone Audio presents The Cold Spot by Tom Piccirilli. For Michelle, warm everywhere, and Ken Bruin, dark-hearted poet with soul ablaze. I hated what I had to do, but the devil drives. Ken Bruin, The Killing of the Tinkers. Part 1. Chase was laughing with the others during the poker game when his grandfather threw down his cards, took a deep pull on his beer, and with no expression at all, shot Walcroft in the head. Only Chase was startled. He leaped back in his seat, knocking over some loose cash and an ashtray, the world tilting left while he went right. Jonah had palmed his .22 in his left hand and had it pressed to Walcroft's temple, a thin trail of smoke spiraling in the air and the smell of burning hair and skin wafting across the table into Chase's face. You'd think it would be disgusting, acrid, but it was actually sort of fragrant. There was almost no blood. One small pop had filled the hotel room, quieter than striking a nail with a hammer. It didn't even frighten the pigeons off the sill. Walcroft blinked twice, licked his lips, tried to rise, and fell over backward as the slug rattled around inside his skull, scrambling his brains. The whites of his eyes turned a bright, glistening red as he lay there clawing at the rug, twitching. The others were already in motion. Chase saw it had been set up in advance, well planned, but nobody had let him in on it. They didn't entirely trust him. Jonah opened the closet door while Grayson and Rook lifted Walcroft's body and carried it across the room. Walcroft was trying to talk, a strange sound coming from far back in his throat. He was blinking, trying to focus his gaze, his hands still trembling. Chase thought, he's staring at me. They tossed Walcroft in the corner of the empty closet, slammed the door, and immediately began cleaning the place. No one looked at Chase, which meant everybody was looking at him. Nobody said anything as they wiped down the room, so that was how it was going to be. The room continued leaning, and Chase had to angle his chin so things would straighten out. He shuddered once, but covered it pretty well by bending and picking up the ashtray. They wouldn't want the butts tossed in the trash. They contained DNA. Maybe. Who the fuck knew? They were evidence anyway. Some keen cop might nail Rook because he always tore the filter off his camels. It was a clue. Chase carefully split the cotton nubs apart, stepped to the bathroom, and threw them in the toilet. He washed out the ashtray. Maybe it was the right thing to do, maybe not. It could be downright stupid. It felt insane. What really mattered was that they had to see he was trying, that he was very much a part of the crew. He dove for the cold spot deep inside himself and seemed to miss it. He couldn't look at his face in the mirror. His heart slammed at his ribs, trying to squeeze through. He noticed he wasn't breathing through his nose, was beginning to pant. He started again. He made sure he left no prints on the toilet handle or around the sink. He tried to move into that place again, and this time felt himself begin to freeze and harden. When he got out of the bathroom, the closet door was open a crack. Walcroft was still squirming and had kicked it back open. One shoe had come off and a folded $100 bill had fallen out. Rook said, "Son of a bitch," grabbed a pillow off one of the beds and drew his .38. Walcroft kept making the sound. Chase knew then he would hear it for years to come, in the harbor of his worst nightmares. And that when his own loneliest moment in the world came to pass, he'd be doing the same thing, making that same noise. Rook stepped into the closet, stuffed the pillow down on Walcroft's face to stifle the shot, and pulled the trigger. There was a loud cough and a short burst of flame. This time the pigeons flew off. With his teeth clenched, Rook tamped out the pillowcase. He nabbed the C-note and shut the door again. That was finally the end of it. Chase was 15, and he'd been...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.